Well, it has several functions. Light is scattered in that forest of wires, so the light absorption is better. And then also, if you look here at the cross section, the light is absorbed vertically, and the charge separation actually occurs perpendicularly.
So
usually you don't want to make flat silicon cells. You don't want to make the layers too thin, because otherwise you can't absorb enough light.
But if you make them too thick, then the charge, which has to be separated vertically, it recombines.
Yeah, the hole and the electron are back together.
Yeah, and here you have separated the two effects.
Could it increase then? Is there a sense of how much this would increase efficiency? Because it seems like it could.
Well, that's why people look into it, and that's sort of the area of third generation photovoltaics, looking at new ways to increase the efficiencies and also make solar cells cheaper. Like here, this method, for example, you could make that on glass substrates or on even stainless steel substrates. Certainly the processes still have to be optimized, but that's what the research is about. Here you can see actually some nanowires that were coated on stainless steel foil, and the coating could be like amorphous silicon, it could be an organic semiconductor, and it just, this nanowire research enables new applications and also